Welcome, everyone. Time once again for the fastest 2 hours in radio. It's time once again for the PM show with Mr. Robert Conrad, legend and a star of stage, screen, film, and now, of course, radio, as we blast this show across the world on the internet and on cable TVs and satellite all across the world. The man of the hour, the reason why we're all here, Mr. Robert Conrad.
Okay, and thank you so much for that. I want to let all of our regulars know that I have to do this because every week we get more listeners. So if you're a new listener, it could be your show if you want it to be. All you have to do is call in, send in, and it's your show. Okay? It's very simple. That's it. And the next thing I wanted to share with you is that I have a tendency to talk about a guy with the hair on his head. Now he has some kind of some kind of scarf.
Well, you know, I got the scarf on because I actually retired the scarf for the season because it's been so hot out here in Southern California. But then this last week it started raining. It rained yesterday.
So. Are you finished?
Yeah, my diatribe is done.
Could I talk?
Yes, please.
So anyway.
Mr. Robert Conrad.
There he is. He's got the scarf. He's got the funky hat. And then he has his goofy layer hair. Right? The layer hair is there. But he's one of the nicest men that I've ever worked with. I love to tease him. I love teasing him. But I don't know if I'd really want to do the show without him because he's the best co-host I've ever worked with.
Probably the best looking co-host too you've had for quite a while.
No,
okay, I'm just joking.
Are you gay?
I just threw that out there.
Are you gay?
No, not really.
That's all right.
Not a whole lot.
Don't fight. Let's have a lot of fun. All right. Yes, so anyway, sir. I wanted to spend that time with us, with our show, explaining to him that he is really top of the line.
Oh, thank you, man.
And he's appeal to your sensitivity about me kidding about his little scarf and his little hat and his little whatever else it is. And he doesn't need any of that. But, you know, you got to be what you pretend to be. That's why I pretend to be a tough guy. Okay.
It's kind of like this is like my driver's cap. So really, I'm trying to be like a Italian driver, like a taxi driver.
Well, you've managed to accommodate that, right?
With my scarf and my hat. Yes. Okay. Anyways, let's get to the
goofy
phone.
I'm
a goofy turd. We're going to do 4 and 8. That's the format today, guys, because we have so many emails. We're going to get four of your phone calls.
Yeah, your emails, we're going to do them. I keep saying that, but, you know, we get so many. Thank God, and thank you.
Yes.
So let's go to Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh.
And to RG in the Pittsburgh. RG, what's up, Bob?
Yeah, how you doing, Bob?
I'm doing fair, man. I'm doing better than I've been doing for like a couple of months. The right arm isn't as painful as it's usually been, so I think I'm going to be on the recovery mode. Next question.
Did you get my letter about your son Shane that I saw him on TV on JAG?
Oh, cool.
Yeah, did you ask him about that?
No, I didn't get that. Now, when Sarah comes back, we got to go there and find out about it. No, I didn't ask him. He's been in charge of decorating this mansion, and he's been really, really busy, but I didn't do that, but I will now that you've asked me to. What else, brother? Can you hear the theme coming in?
Yeah, I sent you a text picture of your son wearing a jungle hat on the movie.
Okay, a jungle movie.
We'll
I don't know.
We'll track it down, RG.
Let's track it. We'll talk. Can we talk to her now when she can come in?
Yeah.
Okay, RG, bro, it's always a pleasure, right? Because who are you?
I'm a Conrad fan.
Hey, no, you're not. Who are you? You're a regular. Whose show is this?
Your show.
No, I'm not talking. It's our show.
Right.
Oh, you are. Say it. Our show.
There we go. We'll be back.
In a minute.
It's the Ace 20% off store-wide bag sale. Come in this Saturday only to stock up and save 20% on almost anything you can fit in the bag, including products from some of our best brands like Valspar. But it's only this Saturday, so don't miss your chance to save with Ace's 20% off store-wide bag sale.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Offer good at participating Ace stores February 20th only. Discount applies to the regular price in-stock merchandise that fits inside the bag. One bag per customer. Power tools and small appliances qualify for a 10% discount. Additional conditions and exclusions apply. See store for details.
At GoDaddy, a domain name is the beginning of something awesome. Use it to create a website to promote your business. Open an online store to sell your products. Start a blog. Build your brand. You can even connect your domain to your LinkedIn or Facebook page. And GoDaddy customer support is always ready to help. What will you do with your domain name? Get a free domain with website from GoDaddy.com, starting at $1 a month. Annual purchase of website builder required. Price valid first year only. See website for details.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what Jupiter is on Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me.
Yes. So we have another engineer tonight.
Fill my heart with song.
We have the illustrious Paul Stern.
Stern, who's a senior. He kind of runs stuff around here. He's like a vice president. But I like to see him behind the screen doing what he's supposed to be, and that's a worker.
As you say that, he's back there eating lunch.
Yeah, I gotta tell you, eat your lunch, mother.
Paul, you know, Paul had quite the Valentine's Day celebration. Paul actually was treated to quite the vacation experience. He was kind of
really?
Oh yeah.
What's the I don't understand. Yeah, wait a minute. Let me say this. The Valentine.
His boo took him out to
his
to,
who?
His boo took him out to Cabo San Lucas.
Wait, I don't understand your language. His boo.
I think that's kind of a loose reference to like his girl.
Boo.
Yeah, his boo.
So you got a boo, huh, bro?
Took him out to Cabo for the week, man. I'm telling you.
She took him to the Cabo.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
How do I find these women? I've been divorced for 6 years. Okay?
Paul's hating
6 years,
now.
Do you know what I said?
Yeah.
And I've seen, in 6 years, one woman once. And move on.
Oh, man, yeah. Yeah, I tell you. Yeah, I had a pretty
I'm not gay, though.
No. Did you do anything special for Valentine's? Did you give old grandma a call and wish her happy Valentine's Day?
Grandma? Are you kidding? Grandma? Our grandma?
Yeah.
Yes, I did.
Okay,
but I don't want to share that. Let's move
okay,
on.
Okay, let's do it. Let's get over. Are we still with RG? Let's just say goodbye to RG formally.
We got to get this whole thing, and
let's
then we go to eight of these. Yes.
RG, we'll say goodbye to you formally, amigo.
AJ.
Hey, this is Clarice.
What?
This is RG's wife, Clarice.
Oh, hey, Clarice. How you doing?
Hey, Clarice. Okay. How you doing?
I just wanted to say hi.
Oh, that's
and
so
that
cool.
Next week, you can sing happy birthday to me.
Okay, listen. Next week is when's your birthday, darling?
I think Saturday next week because I'll be.
What's the date? Give me the date. Give me the date.
27th.
Let's do it because can we do it next Saturday and next Thursday?
We'll
be past it. Clarice, right, darling?
Yes.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Clarice. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. Have a good week and a good month.
And stay with this guy. I don't care what it takes.
Oh, yeah. I picked him. He's a good guy.
Good for you, baby.
Okay. Take care. Love you guys. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. There she goes. There goes Clarice. That's great. I'm glad I went back to RG to talk to Clarice.
That's
cool.
His show, man. That's what we're selling here. We're selling us.
One line open.
And you know what I need? I don't need it. I do it because I love it. I love you people. I love you people for the career you have given me, and I mean that from the very bottom of my heart, and thank you for it. Now let's move on to Val.
Yeah, let's go down south and talk to Val in South Carolina.
Val in South Carolina. Hello, baby. Talk south.
Hello, can you hear me?
Oh, are you kidding me? Who couldn't
awesome.
Hear you? Who couldn't
wonderful.
Hear you?
Wonderful. I wanted to begin by asking you, did you know that today is National Drink Wine Day?
Hey. No, but thank you for sharing.
It is.
Hey, woman. Yeah. I love vino.
Tien and vino.
Awesome.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. I love it.
Wow. What's your favorite wine? Red?
No. My favorite wine is white.
Oh.
White.
Right.
Yeah, that's good with a steak, you know, a good
dinner. No, it's good with anything. Are you kidding me? It's good with a kiss.
There you go.
Oh, baby. Okay.
Yeah.
But, you know, since you guys are there at CRN, and Mike Korn is such a wine person.
He is a winophile. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, he probably has plenty that you could go and choose from.
No, he's cheap.
Just a little bit.
The guy's very cheap. To get a glass of wine out of him, you have to knock him down and break his arm.
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh. Well, you could do that. Well, you used to.
No, I can still do it. Are you kidding me?
Okay, wonderful. Well, I won't make you mad there.
All right, what else, baby? Come on. We got to get moving.
Yeah, I'm going. Okay.
What do you mean I'm going? You don't have to go like
take
that.
Your
just
time.
Calm down.
I'm rushing. You know, I'm trying to get with the program here.
No, yeah, just
take your time.
Cool down
take your
time. And say what you
this
think and
show.
What you mean. It's your show.
It's my show.
All right, everyone, quiet! Yeah. Go, baby.
Action. Okay, yeah. A few months ago, you said that you did not want a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. But I was reading up, and you did receive a star in Santa Clarita, California, at the, it's called the Walk of Western Stars in 1984. Do you remember that?
Yes, I do.
Awesome.
Yeah, thank you.
You are number three. Your star is in between Joel McRae and Steve McQueen.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'll take that.
Western Hall of Fame right there, Santa Clarita, California.
I'll take that.
And I'll tell you guys, for anybody visiting the studios out here, Santa Clarita is only about 15 minutes away from the studio. So if you wanted to come visit, yeah, not very far at all. Not very far at all. No.
Well, I saw a picture of you sitting in between the Lone Ranger, Clayton Moore, and Dennis Weaver, because they were honored that day, and also the late John Wayne.
Well, you know, it was so exciting for me, truly, to sit next to the Lone Ranger. Because as a young guy growing up, I watched the Lone Ranger, and all of a sudden I was being honored with it, and it was a thrill for me. Okay, kid, we got a kid coming in from Germany that I don't adore, I worship. So can I say adios to you?
Yes. Okay, well, love and blessings to you, okay?
Love and blessings to you, baby. Stay with us, and as long as you do,
will.
You will. And whose show is it?
It's mine.
You got
it
right.
No, and Eric's.
That's all
and
right.
Next time you come on, why don't you wear some earrings, you know, to compliment Eric's attire?
You want me to wear earrings?
Oh, boy.
Did you
say that?
Oh, boy.
You want me to wear earrings?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, a couple earrings. And,
yeah.
You know, get
you
a
know what? I'll
wig.
Probably I'll probably never speak to you again.
You better.
All right, baby.
I'll come and get you.
All right, let me talk to Bettina.
There we go. Hola.
Hola, Bettina.
There we go. Oh, we going to Bettina? Let's go to Bettina. All the way in Germany. Bettina, you're on the show.
Yes, hello, good afternoon, guys. How are you doing?
Let me say something to you. You might think this is an insincere compliment, you know, because those things happen all the time. But I haven't heard your music until I pulled into the driveway. How long ago was that, Sarah? Half hour ago. The music is absolutely me. It's so magnificent that it is so tender, so emotional. When I'm happy, I'm happier. When I'm sad, I'm very sad. And all I can do is thank you, girl. Thank you for being a part of my life, and thank you for giving me that music. Okay, now next, let's get up and talk about something.
You are spoken like a true romanticist.
thanks to you, I am.
Mm-hmm. Listen, my call tonight is a bit of a personal nature because you always say it's our show, and I normally wouldn't have even called because my mind is understandably elsewhere these days. But I have to tell you something. Due to your show, I have gained some incredible friends from the chat room, and I would like to just point out three ladies that I would like to give my thanks here on the air as well. There's Susan from Rhode Island, who's become a most cherished friend, and then I have to mention these two fantastic Boston girls, Susie and Donna, and I would like to ask a big favor of you. Please don't criticize that Boston accent all the time. They have a heart of gold, and I love them dearly. Okay?
I can't help it. I come from Chicago.
Yeah.
I grew up talking like this, and when I hear her talking like that, I have to have fun with it, okay?
Well,
I'm not criticizing it. I'm applauding it. She can't speak like we do because, you know, she comes from the dark ages.
She's an individual.
Thank you, darling.
Okay, well, I'll let you go. Have fun. Thanks for taking my call.
Okay, can I ask you a question?
Yes, go ahead.
Was ist los?
What is los? What's going on?
Yeah.
Well, you know, my mom's in hospital and she's still in a critical condition, so that's why I haven't been listening to the show
very
much.
I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry.
So I'm just popped in tonight.
Hang in there, sweetie.
God bless you, baby. Bye-bye.
CRN travelers, relax at the beautiful Fountain Grove Inn and Conference Center in Santa Rosa, California. Come to quality and come to luxury. Experience the newly renovated guest rooms. They're generously sized and they're decorated in the Tuscan tradition. They have great, incredible pillow top mattresses, luxurious linens, and down-filled comforters. The Fountain Grove Inn also offers complimentary Wi-Fi and internet access. There's warm cookies and coffee every evening in the hotel lobby, and you can visit the newly remodeled Equus Restaurant and Equus Lounge with its new wine bar. It's the ideal place to relax and enjoy a glass of wine and watch our What's Cooking on Wine show on CRN with host Larry Van Alst on Wednesdays. It's the Fountain Grove Inn, Hotel, and Conference Center, located in the heart of Sonoma wine country. It's easily located in Santa Rosa off the 101 Fountain Grove Parkway exit. Call 707-578-6101. That's 707-578-6101 or visit fountaingroveinn.com.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names.
Really? Yeah.
They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-471-5173, 800-471-5173.
Try Fry Vineyards, the Mendocino County organic wine with no sulfites added. Fry Wines, America's pioneering organic winery. They were the first to go organic, the first maker of certified biodynamic wines in the United States. At Fry Wines, our emphasis is on producing organic wine of the highest quality while caring for our planet and palate alike. Check out our website at frywine.com and join the Fry Vineyards Wine Club. You'll receive 20% off all orders and much more. Plus, you can check out our internet-only specials. Great biodynamic wines from Redwood Valley in Mendocino County, California. Fry Wines. Go to frywine.com. That's F-R-E-Y-W-I-N-E. Fry Wine. F-R-E-Y-W-I-N-E.com. Check it out and enjoy great wines at your home tonight.
Estas sobre la playa de Caleta y el mar. Te baña y acaricia tu belleza sin par. Estas entre mis brazos y me dejas besar. Tu boca primorosa de coral, el mar aquí en Caleta es más azul, y todo es como un sueño si estás tú.
Welcome back, everybody. It is the PM show. Mela Kaliki Maka. Actually, that means Merry Christmas, doesn't it? You're a little early for that. The voice of course, Mr. Robert Conrad. Singing in Hawaiian, of course, the land of love.
Singing in Hawaiian?
Is that Hawaiian?
That's Spanish.
See, there you go.
Take That's, off that little drape gotta, and you'll hear it.
It's getting hot in the studio. I must be a little lightheaded.
Getting hot in your head.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, guys. Welcome back to the show. It is your show. Give us a call.
818. It's Hawaiian. Are you serious?
Apparently, I'm not.
No, he's taking off his dress.
It must be cutting off circulation to my brain.
God bless you.
There we go.
He just took off his dress.
I've actually been to Hawaii and Mexico, and somehow I confused both of those.
Okay, good. Now, where are we going?
Totally different places. Let's get over to emails. Susie Boston.
You want to do Susie Boston? No, we do Brian, and then... Mary, wait a minute. Come on, put these in the right order. We'll do Susie, then Brian, then Mary, and then we'll do
this. It's
like
a rock and roll name, Susie Boston.
I can't believe that the boss is here and he's screwing up. Okay, let's go to Susie in Boston.
Let's go to Susie Boston. Hey, Susie Boston, welcome to the show.
Susie Boston, talk us to you.
Hi, hello, boss.
Hey, Susie.
Eric and Sarah.
There she is.
Hi, hello. Take off that. Oh, please, engineer.
We're picking on Paul today.
Now.
Let's hammer it on Paul.
Okay, what's up, baby?
Okay. Okay, can I ask a general question about acting, Bob?
You can ask any question, intimate, general, or passionate.
Well, oh, really? Well, for tonight, no, I do have an intimate a question. Okay, when you're doing your movies, and like your agent calls and says, "Oh, I have this part for you," well, like let's just say the Pascanel. Do they send you the whole script for the movie, or just the section that you're going to be in? Or what? How does that work?
Well, that's a unique experience because we're talking about Michener, one of the great artists of America.
Oh, yeah. So it's different for each movie?
Well, that's a exceptionally different experience because they said, guess what? This is an opportunity for you. And I looked at the property and I went, oh, my gosh.
Oh, boy.
Well, it was made for you. It was made for you.
I guess so. But that's an exception. Like just recently in the last, how many days, Sarah?
How many days what?
About me being offered that last film.
Oh, in the last week?
Yeah, last week. So the last week there was an opportunity for me. And
it was casual.
So we want him to play this and this and that. And, oh. And my agent said, what do you think? I said, I don't know. What do you think? Because it doesn't have the same passion that something like Centennial had. And that was the greatest experience.
Right.
Well, that was the greatest experience of my acting career. Next, quick.
Oh, no, I just wanted to know, so is it different when you're, like, preparing things, like, for movies than for when you did, like, TV series? Were you just, like, only a show ahead?
No, you know what it is. It's always passion. It's always what you believe. A movie is a movie. It's all acting. It doesn't make any difference where they play it. They play it on the big screen, and they play it on the smaller screen, or they play it in the lobby. It's all the same.
Well, I'm just so glad that you did not only TV shows but movies.
Thank you, darling. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
And I can tell you a number of guys that agree with you.
There we go.
Yeah. Well, we all agree with you here.
Thank you, darling.
And I'm glad that your right arm is doing better because it's almost your birthday, and we've been praying that you're feeling a lot better March 1st, so I'm so glad to hear that news.
It's getting better, and this is probably the best day I've had in months, and thank you for saying
that. Well, you look fantastic tonight.
Well, good. You know what I want to do tonight, don't you?
What?
Go to sleep early.
Well, hey, I do too. Early to bed and early to rise.
Well, I don't know about early
makes
to
a
rise.
Girl healthy, wealthy, and
I like the early to bed part. All right, thanks for the call, baby girl.
Okay, thank you. God bless you. I love you.
God bless you.
Bye.
I love you. And stay a part of your show. Whose show is it?
It's my show and your show. It's our show.
Oh, gosh. I love that. So true.
There we go.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Take care, everybody.
Hey, thank Bye-bye. You, Susie. All right, we call her Susie Boston. That's her new rock and roll name. Yeah, that's
now,
here we go.
Now, what do we have before we come into commercial?
We're going to go to Brian
Nashville. And
Nashville.
After Brian, we do Mary. Nashville, we do Brian, and then we do 8 of these.
Yes, sir.
And then
back to the phones. Yeah.
Then you do 4, and then we do 8. Right?
We'll do it. Yeah.
Thank you. Isn't this little girl cute? This little girl?
I think my wife's actually listening to the show today, Bob.
I want her to listen. This is a little girl.
Just to check up on me.
You know what her name is?
This is Sarah.
No, her name's Polaka.
What is it? Oh, God. We'll have to find out.
Sarah Polaka.
We'll be back right after this.
The legends of Kaanapali Luau at the Kaanapali Beach Hotel will take your breath away with an abundant feast, spellbinding dances and music from Le Pono Productions. Be greeted with a lei and browse to see island crafts made by local artisans. As you hear the pu or conch shell blow, your luau experience will begin. The featured entree is a whole roasted pig and a bountiful menu of some of Hawaii's favorite food choices. Oh, you can't forget our famous made-in-house taro poi. As your night comes to an end under the spell of the moon, be amazed by the famous firewalk. By the end of the night, you'll be full, and we hope you'll have made new friends and some forever memories while you continue to listen to music from Maui's local Hawaiian musicians every Monday night at Hawaii's most Hawaiian hotel. Kaanapali Beach Hotel, voted best Aloha Spirit by Hawaii Magazine readers. Call 667-0128 or visit legendsofkaanapali.com for your exciting island adventure.
When you really want Italian food, you've got to go to Columbo's. Columbo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club, Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. It's that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. If you haven't been to Columbo's, you don't know what you're missing. Delicious food. The steaks of this side are fabulous. The seafood's so fresh and flavorful. Columbo's family Italian specialties are Southern California legendary, and the meatballs, the best in the West, North, South, and East. Plus service that's friendly but not fawning, and jazz every night, and it's all so affordable. That's what makes Columbo special, and they make special easy, whether for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. That's why when you really want Italian food, you've got to go to Columbo's, because it really is that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Columbo's, making special easy every day. Columbo's, mangia.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
Are you nearing eligibility for Medicare benefits? Then you know now is an important time in your life. Medicare benefits can be a complicated puzzle. You don't want to overpay for your Medicare coverage or get the wrong plan. Let Health Markets Insurance Agency help you. With one free phone call, a licensed insurance agent will help you select a Medicare plan that's right for you and your budget. If you're becoming eligible for Medicare, call today and learn how to get the most out of your benefits.
800-793-1960. 800-793-1960.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is the DBA or assumed name of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc., which is an authorized insurance agency in all 50 states and the District of Columbia. Not all agents are licensed to sell all products. Service and product availability varies by state.
Call 800-793-1960. 800-793-1960. 800-793-1960. 800-793-1960.
In this cold world, no matter where I go, the clouds are all the same. To them, I'm just a pebble in the sand, a face without a name. Nobody gives a hang for what I say or do, but you, and in the shelter of your arms, I find peace and comfort and care. For I am wanted there.
Welcome back, everybody. The voice of Sammy D. And we're bringing you back into this, your show, the PM show with Mr. Robert Conrad. We are taking your calls, 818-353-1276. But more importantly, we are getting to your C-mails, as we call them. You're the Robert Conrad emails.
Well, what's more important, it's your show. It is your show. It is your show. I can't belabor it more because I'm so excited about the fact that I have a show that's shared with the people that helped me with my career. And not only did you help me, you made it. And now we've got this young guy over here, and he's a very, very talented guy, and we paid him all the credit we can pay him. He should probably give me a check later, but that'll be after when the show's over, right?
I'll sign it cash for you.
Okay, and then the beautiful Sarah.
Yeah.
Do we give credit to the beautiful Sarah?
I want to ask Sarah how her Valentine's Day was.
Oh, it was very good.
It was good? It was nice. It was good. It was kind of thrown together at the last minute, but we made it work, and we had a lot of fun. We stayed out
now, Sarah,
way too late.
Be 100% honest. You know how I am in our relationship, right? Mm-hmm. What did I give you for Valentine's Day?
Nothing.
Thank you.
You're such a sweetheart.
My Valentine, man.
Flowers and chocolate covered strawberries at home.
You know who my Valentine is? Who's my Valentine?
I would say it would be goes by the name of G-Ma.
You got it, Grandma. Yeah, where Grandma. Are you, baby girl? I called you last night. You didn't answer. I called you this morning. You didn't answer. I called you this afternoon. You didn't answer. So all I can assume is something is serious. And I'm going to pray for you, baby, because I have something serious really going on in my own life, which I'll address on
Saturday.
Yeah, Saturday. First, I read an article that you're an owner of an old brand fragrance for teen and restaurant chain. Do you confirm? Second question, is it true that Charles Bronson was selected for the cast role of James West and Pappy Boyington? Thank you so much, Jean-Luc. I don't know about that, Jean-Luc, about who was chosen to play the role in the Black Sheep Squadron. I do know that a fragrance for teens is something I'm not even aware of. But if I had been one, I would have gotten it. I would have put all of my teen body back in those days and go, hello, little girl. No, I'm teasing. That's not a perv. Or am I? Am I a perv?
A little bit.
Thank you. At least I don't wear a scarf.
Hey, no, believe me, I'm full-blown perv. That's okay.
No, you don't wear a scarf.
I own that one.
Hey, Bobby, Larry Arbath. It's been a while since we talked. How are you, man? Living in Detroit at this time, but I will be moving to your area soon. I look up my son on YouTube, and there's no crazy jazz fan. Listen to us music. Hope to see you soon and talk about our Chicago times. Get in touch with me. You know, you get in touch with me, which you did, sent from AOL Mobile. Hey, good for you, man. Okay, good for you. It's nice for you to touch base with me again. The Chicago Gypsy. You like that?
Huh? There you go.
No, Sarah grabs it, doesn't know what I'm talking about, the Chicago Gypsy. Can you tell her where Chicago is?
It's a beautiful place.
It's in Europe, right?
Yeah, it's located right near the island of the UK.
Oh, okay.
Over there, they speak Gypsy.
Okay.
And you speak.
Oh, is that what Robert's speaking all the time?
That's right, Gypsy.
Oh, dearest Darcy, last week you talked about your friend Richard Marks that you had known since you said he was 16. I found this picture of him and also yourself when you were making the Hazard video. You were dressed up like a deputy sheriff. Here, the picture you are talking to him and some others. This picture is just of our back sides before you lost all of your weight, which I did. Thanking you in 2000. Did you recall that you were feeling these folks here about the acting and the directing would be payable? Payable would be, yeah, maybe. Okay. And it says, love and blessings, Valentine Augustine.
Oh, Val.
You know what?
That's Val.
What do you mean that's Val?
That's Val that calls in all the time.
Oh, our Val.
Yes, that's our Val.
All right, good. She goes, hear that? Just throws it in there. Could you hear that? It's our Val. Okay. Hey, Robert. I'm Jody. I'm a big fan of the Wild, Wild West. Oh, thanks, sweetheart. I'm trying to obtain the final 13 or so episodes of the Black Sheep Squadron. How can you help me order them? Baby, I don't know. How can we help her order them? Can you help me?
We'll find out. Yeah, what is she exactly asking for?
She's finding the last 15 scenes of the Wild, Wild West.
The Wild, Wild West.
Black Sheep Squadron.
Oh, Black Sheep Squadron. I'm sorry. Sarah?
Yes.
Thank you. You're so wonderfully talented.
Thank you.
To have corrected me with that. Can you tell that Sarah and I have no hostility directed toward each other? Oh, well.
That's what you think.
But you know what I like about you, Sarah?
What?
You're cute. Hey, I just saw the Chocolate Man and remind me of you. I added your name and shared the picture with some other fans of yours. We all told me to send it to you because they thought it was cute. Oh, hey, how's your physique? It's good, thank you for asking. And the hair style you had in the salary, it's the same. All the very best to you. Marlita, I think I'll eat the feet first. I don't know what that means. All right, God bless you, Marlita. Okay, now I only do 10. How many have I done so far?
I think you're actually hitting that number right now, sir.
Okay, really?
Yeah.
You call me sir?
Yes, sir.
I thought we were partners.
We are partners, sir.
Nice salute. First Marine Surf Battalion Weapons Company. Can I try that one more
time? Hoo-ah! Very good.
When I was over there in Lebanon, it was interesting.
Man. Right, they're going to do a documentary about that one of these days.
Yeah, sure. Milk chocolate, and Oh, my goodness. It's an interesting picture. Okay, thank you so much. All right, now may I do one more?
You know, I'm surprised that we don't get, well, I'm not going to say it.
Surprised we don't get what? Go on, say it.
Well, you know, you hear these stories about people sending in inappropriate pictures of themselves to stars.
Yeah, but that's not us. This is a I wonder if, no, this is a show where we're all
it's pretty inappropriate.
No, seriously. It's a show about us. It's about her, him, me. It's about Brian. It's about Mary. It's about Terry.
It's about a Bob Conrad chocolate wearing boxers. That's what it's about.
Oh, that's funny, you turkey.
That is a Bob Conrad chocolate wearing boxers.
Are we finished with these interviews?
Somebody's going to put this in their mouth.
You're a pervert. Let me ask you a question.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Are we finished with this? And we go
we're going back to the phone, sir. It's my turn up next.
It's your turn.
Yeah.
We go to the phones.
Yes, sir.
Right, be polite to this guy because he has a slow mentality.
We'll be back right after this.
CRN travelers, relax at the beautiful Fountain Grove Inn and Conference Center in Santa Rosa, California. Come to quality and come to luxury. Experience the newly renovated guest rooms. They're generously sized and they're decorated in the Tuscan tradition. They have great, incredible pillow top mattresses, luxurious linens, and down-filled comforters. The Fountain Grove Inn also offers complimentary Wi-Fi and internet access. There's warm cookies and coffee every evening in the hotel lobby, and you can visit the newly remodeled Equus Restaurant and Equus Lounge with its new wine bar. It's the ideal place to relax and enjoy a glass of wine and watch our What's Cooking On Wine show on CRN with host Larry Van Alst on Wednesdays. It's the Fountain Grove Inn, Hotel, and Conference Center located in the heart of Sonoma wine country. It's easily located in Santa Rosa off the 101 Fountain Grove Parkway exit. Call 707-578-6101. That's 707-578-6101 or visit fountaingroveinn.com.
Are you worried about losing your home to foreclosure? If you've been threatened with foreclosure or receive legal papers from your bank, you have approximately 30 days to respond. If you do not respond, you could lose your home. You have rights. Act now to protect your rights. You can stay in your home. Many times you can even modify your loan. The bottom line is you can get past this, but you must act right now. If you've been served by your bank and you're worried about losing your home to foreclosure, now is the time to fight back and save your home. Time is limited, so call the professionals at National Foreclosure Defense right now.
800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. That number again is 800-515-6309.
Spanish eyes, teardrops are falling from your Spanish eyes. Please, please don't cry. This is just adios and not goodbye. Soon I'll return, bringing you all the love your heart can hold. Please say, si, si. Say you and your Spanish eyes will wait for me.
Welcome back. It's the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad, and we are...
Don't do that anymore. It's with Robert Conrad, and it's with you.
Yeah.
You are our audience. Without you, we're not here. And he is my associate, my co-partner. And if he says the Robert Conrad, the Robert... Enough! All right?
That's it.
Well, you promise?
I'll try.
Well, I'm going to try and help you.
I'm not perfect. But
no, I know you aren't. I learned it. But you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to call your wife.
Don't call my wife.
No, I'm going to call her and I'm going to tell her you're cheating on
him. Oh, no, don't do that. Don't do that.
No,
don't
say, guess what? I saw him with her.
She'll say, which one? That's the problem.
I know both of them because one of them used to be mine.
Don't say that. Don't say that. She'll kill me. All right, guys. Remember, this is your show. Give us a call, 818-353-1276. 818-353-1CRN, as our good buddy John the Voice would say. And, you know, I don't seem to remember us hearing from John the Voice yet today.
No, he's not here. He doesn't care.
Could Wait I have some more of that baby? No, John. I got your back cold. On this one, buddy.
No, John doesn't care.
No, John's no, obviously.
No, he's playing a shooting pool somewhere in Poland.
No, I have a feeling that, you know, he probably went on some great Valentine's weekend vacation with the wife and they're still
All
recovering.
All I know is he didn't call. He's not here, and we can forgive him because it's his show.
We'll forgive him.
Yeah. No, it's his show. We have nothing to forgive. Without him, you know, it's the next step up. It'd be like Brian in Nashville, who's a friend of his. Can we find Brian in Nashville?
Yeah, let's do to Brian in Nashville. Hey, Brian. How's
it's
it going,
your
buddy?
Show, bro.
Hello, everybody. How you doing?
Hello, everybody.
Y'all doing all right?
I'm doing good.
Uncle Bob, I got a favor to ask of you.
Can you hear me? Yeah, I can hear you.
Go ahead and ask the question.
Hey, someone asks you for a favor. You got to sit and find out what it is first.
Yeah, here. Uncle Bob, I got a question to ask for you. It's a favor.
I got a favor.
And guess what? Then it goes silent.
It's an easy one.
Well, I can tell you, Brian, is I hope you know what the favor is.
Okay. Well, I want you to sing happy birthday for my mom.
Oh, great. What's her name?
Betty?
Uh-huh. Shoot. Where is she?
Right here. Say hi.
Hey, Betty.
Hello.
Hey, Betty. How you doing, girl?
I'm fine. How are you?
Well, I'm better now. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Betty. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
For my 81st birthday.
Your what birthday?
81.
Hey, baby, we're the same age. You know what happens to me on the 1st of March?
Mine is the 18th of February.
Well, mine will be the 1st of March, and you know what I'm going to sing?
Pardon?
I'm going to see. Can I tell you what I'm going to sing on my 81st birthday?
Oh, yeah, I'll be glad to.
No, I'm going to tell you. You ready to hear it?
Yeah.
I'm out there having fun in the warm California sun. Okay?
I wish I could.
God bless you, you little pretty.
Thank you.
Hey, you done made my daddy mad now. Look out.
Say what?
I said, you done made my daddy mad now. He's coming out there.
Well, I'll tell your lady, go out and get a job and shut up.
No, hey, listen, thank you so much for doing that. I mean it.
No, thank you for asking me, because she sounds cute.
Oh, she is.
Well, I'm sure she is, or I wouldn't have sung to her.
Hey, she sent you pecan pie one time. I can probably talk her into sending you another.
Why not? All right. How's everything else?
Oh, everything's good. Everything's good. I just wanted to say hi, and I appreciate you doing that. I'm going to step aside and let somebody else get on.
Well, be a part of it, man. Be a part of it. Be a part of it. Because it's your. Whose show is it?
This is our show.
God, I love that. You know, I never could have believed with the career that I've had, and I've God blessed for it, that one day I'd be able to sit here in a studio and say to all of us, thank you. And it's so exciting. And thank you.
Thank you for allowing us to call you and talk to you. And thanks for being my friend.
Okay, brother. Say hi to your mom again. If she wants to run away, I'm here.
Okay. My dad said he might disagree with you on that one.
tell your dad to mind his own business.
All right, I will. All
right,
thanks, Uncle Bob.
All right, so long, bro.
See you.
There we go. There goes Brian in Nashville. Probably one of my favorite callers. Next to John the Voice is probably Brian in Nashville. Are we doing this? Are we heading over to
Mary? No, that's it. Then we go back to this, and then we come back to that, to Terry and to Donna, and then we go back. Terry and Brian. Then we get rid of the beautiful Mary Vermont. Mary, how are you, my darling?
Hello, how are you?
Oh, I'm good. Thank you so much for my lovely present for, what was that called? It's Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day? Oh, you're entirely welcome, my dear.
You're so sweet. Now, we're going to commercial, so when we come back, you're still with us, aren't you?
Oh, sure.
Are you happy?
I'm very happy. Are you happy?
Mixed emotions. I got some personal problems, but don't we all? Isn't that what makes...
That's it. Man.
That's who we are, right?
I'm sorry to hear that.
I'm sorry to have it, but hang in there. We go to commercial, which pays for all this time we spend together. Then we come back, and Mary, quite contrary,
How does your garden grow?
Hang in there, Mary. I'll try to be very contrary.
We'll be back right after this.
Let me take just a moment or two, if I may, and talk about a great place to eat. That's right, for you folks anywhere in the eastern San Fernando Valley, drop in to Bob's Big Boys. That's right, in Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. Now, everybody remembers the name Bob's. They're getting bigger and bigger every day. And little old Bob carrying the hamburger in his checkered overalls is the same Bob that you remember from back through the years. And, of course, if you want to go in for a great lunch, remember their classic burger, the original double-deck hamburger combination. Delicious 100% pure ground beef in two patties with American cheese, lettuce, and our famous Big Boy special sauce. The name is Bob, and I think when you go in, you'll say, by golly, I'm sure glad that I found this restaurant because it's good for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. They've got all kinds of things, and all you have to do is remember. Bob's Big Boy in Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. It's a great place to eat.
Experience the romantic getaway you deserve at Maui's premier bed and breakfast, the Plantation Inn. With plantation-style architecture and decor combined with modern amenities such as dual rain showers and whirlpool hot tubs, guests relax in a tranquil oasis in the heart of Maui's historic Lahaina town. The inn is situated conveniently less than 2 blocks from Lahaina Harbor, as well as the famous French Street, known for its range of shops, restaurants, gallery walks, and museums. The Plantation Inn is home to Gerard's Restaurant, voted Open Table's top most romantic restaurants in North America. Chef Gerard's contemporary island French cuisine consistently earns some of the highest ratings in Hawaii. Come discover why Hawaii Magazine readers named the Plantation Inn number one best bed and breakfast in Hawaii. Visit theplantationinn.com or call us at 667-9225.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
I can only give you love that lasts forever, and the promise to be near each time we call. And the only heart I own is for you and you alone. That's all.
That's all.
That's all. I can only
give you
walks in springtime,
and I do promise to be each
begin to fall,
call.
And the all
no, it's different lyrics. I'm singing different lyrics, but I love this guy.
Beautiful nonetheless, Mr. Conrad.
Oh, he's beautiful.
The voice of Mel Torme, Hyde Park
Mel,
High School.
Mel.
Yeah.
High School, Horte, Mel.
Yeah, very good. Let's get over back to Mary. We never formally said goodbye, and I'm sure I think it sounded like Mary still had a little bit more to say. Let's get her on. Mary, welcome.
Who
to
wants
your show.
To say goodbye to Mary?
Yes, hi. Well, thank you.
Quite contrary,
and
baby.
Eric,
hey,
and
Mary.
Sarah.
Mary, a question.
Yes.
How does the garden grow, baby?
Oh, it grows. I'm telling you, it grows and grows. It's
sugar
beautiful.
Nice.
It's the best growing I've ever had.
And everything nice.
Everything's nice.
Ooh. All right, go ahead. What's on your mind?
I had a question about Centennial.
And go ahead, baby. I have an answer about Centennial.
I'm sure you do. I was wondering if at any time during the production of Centennial, was there ever a gathering of all the actors who took part in that, you know, for the whole 26 hours or so?
No.
They never got together?
Never.
As a group?
Never.
Oh, that's too bad.
I didn't think so. I thought the first 5 hours was the best part of Centennial.
Oh, well, yeah, I still don't know how it ends.
I don't either, because I never watched it past the first
5 hours.
No,
me either.
When I see Pascanel get killed by that freaking Indian, I went, oh, shucks.
Yeah, that freaking Indian. He's no, I'm no friend of his either.
A mean guy.
He was a mean guy for sure.
But Pascanel was older then. It was fine for him to move on, because there was no, back in those days, there was no Viagra. There was no, what's that other stuff they take nowadays? What?
Cialis.
No Cialis. It just all
passed
away.
Well, I'll be honest with you. I doubt that he would have needed that.
Oh, but I don't know, because we never got to use it. You know why? Because she was an Indian. And she'd go, oh, but jump up and down. I said, hey, baby, just calm down. Quit bumping the bed up and down.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
This conversation.
Whoa!
I'm glad your arm is feeling better.
It's getting better. Everything's getting better.
That's great. I'm glad about that.
You know what I'm taking now?
Oh, boy.
What are you taking now?
Starts with a V, ends with the Viagra.
No, it's not. No, it's not at all. Can I say it or no?
Yes, you can say it to me.
Okay. It's Valabra.
Valabra?
It's an offshoot brand of, yeah.
Which means it goes three different
generic
ways.
Brand.
It's a generic brand.
But you stay out of it. I got this little teenage assistant who's got a 15-year-old and lives with a guy for 7 years, a Latino, and she gets in there and talks all the time about what she thinks I'm thinking. How would you know?
What
the? Huh?
What was that?
You weren't even born when I was taking Valala.
Get a string, sounds like.
Huh? Seriously, I was taking Valala. What did she know?
Oh, boy. Oh, okay. Mary, thank you so much for calling.
So long, Mary.
Bye, Mary.
And if
you
they take
care.
If they take Palala, close your eyes and look up at the ceiling.
Oh, there it is. Oh, this went way too far. Where's the family? Kids, it's like that Deadpool movie. I hope you didn't take your kids to see this episode of the show.
Palala's a good thing to take. You know what it does?
How
it makes your sure, no. All it does. Can I tell you what it does? Seriously, Palala does one thing.
One thing very well.
It makes your nose longer.
All right, Pinocchio, we'll get out of here. We'll be back.
Thank you.
Stick around. The news break and more right here on the PM Show with Mr. Robert Conrad. Don't go.
Who's our engineer?
Anywhere. We'll be back. It's Paul. We'll be back.
Hey, Paul.
Which was most appropriate because that was your theme.
Are you tired of hearing your favorite talk radio show sound like this? What if you could hear your favorite?